Jeff Baker with Seabreeze Computers. How do you upgrade the RAM in a newer laptop that doesn't have an easy access compartment for the RAM? It used to be that just a few years ago, there was always an easy access compartment with just one little screw. But now it seems with HP laptops and other laptops, you have to completely take apart the laptop in order to reach the RAM slots. So maybe you got a laptop, maybe an HP laptop a few years ago that only came with 8 gigs of RAM, but it can probably go up to 32 gigabytes of RAM if you get 2 16-gigabyte RAM chips, DDR4, 3200, SODIMMs, and you can put those inside of the laptop. But you need a service manual to figure out how to take it apart sometimes. And when you go to HP's website at the moment, it is June 2025, and you look up the service manual for a bunch of laptops, and it is showing that they're not found on HP's website. So I had to go to HP's forum, and another user kindly showed me how I could find the service manual for these laptops at manualslib.com. So I'll share that with you in this video, and I'll share with you taking apart the bottom of the laptop so that we can replace or upgrade the RAM on the HP 17-inch laptop with various model numbers. So here we go. If you're not sure if you've turned the computer completely off or shut down Windows, then go ahead and turn the computer on, go into Windows, and then do the Windows shutdown by clicking on the Windows Start button, and then clicking on the Power button, and then click on Shut Down. Don't click on update or shutdown or any of those, just shut down. And when it's completely shut down, listen for it. Make sure all the fans are off. Make sure there's no clicking. And now it's done, no fans. Make sure we unplug the power cord. Make sure we unplug any devices on it. So I'm gonna unplug the USB for this wireless mouse. And then we're gonna close it and we're gonna turn it around. Now it used to be that you could take one screw out and there would be a little compartment here that you could remove a little piece of plastic and change the memory. But no more. That was just a few years ago. Now on the newer laptops, they want you to take out almost a dozen screws, remove these strips in order to get inside of the laptop. And you gotta take the whole bottom off in order to change the memory on the laptop. So first we remove the screw for the DVD drive on this HP 17 laptop. Put the screws in order over here, and that makes it so we can pull out the optical drive. That pulled right out. And we gotta remove the other screws. Put the screws in the same order, same position. So now we got to remove this strip by trying to peel it. Maybe if I had a flathead screwdriver, this would be easier. There we go. I got in on the right side. You just pull it up. That strip goes over here. We'll put it upside down over here so it doesn't stick to the table. We'll get this one on the right side. Slowly peel it up. This one's more stuck. Put it upside down so it doesn't stick to the table. Now we got 1, 2, 3, 4 screws at the top. My screwdriver head barely fits there, and you see you have to have a magnetic screwdriver because they put them deep inside a little pit here. Otherwise, you won't be able to get the screw out without magnet. And now we got 1, 2 screws on the bottom. And they say to try to take the bottom plate off by starting at the optical drive. But that doesn't look like it's going to work because I see 2 screws here. Do I have to take those screws off? It sure looks like I do to peel that off. Okay, let's go ahead and take these screws out. Now we start. They say to use a non-scratching plastic tool. There we go. You just kind of pull up on this corner here. And the snaps kind of start coming off. But then it's stuck. Let's pull up on this. Slowly pull up. Boy, I didn't make it this way. And it finally comes off. So we'll just lay this over like that. So here we have the inside of the laptop. We got the hard drive here, and we have the RAM up here. Now they say to be safe, take the battery out, even though the power is completely off, because I guess you can accidentally turn the power on. So you want to take the battery out in order to not have an electrostatic shock on the motherboard. Start on the top right. You kind of start from the top and push it downwards. And then slide out a little with angling the bottom up a little bit. Lay this up here. All right, we got the battery out. So now we're a little bit safer with taking the RAM out. There's a little notch on the left side and a little notch on the right side. There's little springs. You wanna just move them sideways and then the memory will flip up. When you put those two clip springs sideways, and then you just grab the memory at the top and just pull it right out. They say don't touch any part of the memory, only the sides. So I touch the top where there's no metal and just the sides. So I'll put that memory to the side, and we got DDR4-3200 SODIMM notebook memory, 32 gigabyte kit, 2 times 16 gigabytes. So each one of these is 16 gigabytes. Grab the memory just from the sides. Try not to touch any metal. So we're gonna put one of them on this side. You just kind of put it at this little bit of an angle and put the bottom right in there. And when it's snug in there, from the top, you push it down and the two clips will automatically go in, the two spring clips on the side. That is inside. Careful grabbing this on the edges. And we're gonna go opposite way into this other slot over here. You have to turn this one backwards. That's the way the slot is there. The little notch shows you that you can only do it one way. So we're gonna turn this one upside down. A little bit of an angle. Make sure it's all the way in snug. And then push it down at the top. And the two clips, spring clips, will go right into the notches on the sides. And we're gonna put the laptop back together, the HP 17-BY laptop back together by first taking the battery and putting it into place. Little bit of an angle, get the top in and then push it straight up, lay it flat. We got four screws. Magnetic screwdriver comes in handy by putting it on the tip and getting it in the hole. Don't do it super tight because you don't want to strip the screws. The bottom plastic piece of the laptop back on. When we took it off, we started at the corner of the optical drive. So now we're gonna start on the opposite corners. Get it on there somehow. The rubber thing came with it. We don't want that yet, because it was the wrong one. Okay. How do we get these corners snapped into place? I guess you just put it on and then you snap it down by pressing until you hear snaps. I think it's on, and you just go from this top edge all the way over, snapping, bottom edge. Keep pushing until it snaps into place. Then on this left edge. And down here. We're gonna put these flat screws in near the entryway of the optical drive. Little notches that go in the holes. So I pull that one out, take the optical drive, slide it in. Perfectly straight. Doesn't want to go in. Why not? Something's stopping it. Why is it being stopped? These are flush. I think it got in all the way this time. I just had to push on the edges really hard. I don't know why. I'm now gonna put the USB receiver for the wireless mouse back into the side. And I'm gonna plug in the laptop. Get the little notch here for the screen and turn it on for the second time. All right, so it seems to be booting up into Windows fine. So again, you want to run a few applications, make sure there's no blue screens, make sure there's no errors. Click on Start and do System Info again. Click on System Information. We have installed physical memory RAM, 32 gigabytes installed. Success.